individual, I believe in world peace, and to many people, world peace is the peace amongst nations. But I would think that, you know, all people are born equal on this universe. And I think the humanity is the peace which every nation should try to achieve. Because when a nation achieves humanity, that's the peace for the world. And because of this humanity, I think there will be a number of nations which will achieve this world peace. The other aspect is this world peace is going to bring about a change in healthcare, technology, as well as equal rights. Also, it would have an impact on the socio-economic conditions. I think that even if 25% of world peace is, you know, we achieve 25%, then it would have an impact of around 2% on the GDP. So I think we should all work towards the world peace.
Thank you for your lovely answer. And what do we mean, inner peace? What do we mean by inner peace? And how we can attain this?
Inner peace is the pathway to world peace. And for me, being in a lot of charitable institutes, inner peace is the smile which comes on my patient's face, the smile which is there for the students, which comes from the humanitarian work and the philanthropy which comes in. So I think that is what inner peace means to me. Thank you.
Thank you for your lovely answer. Thank you. Anjana ji, congratulations on being felicitated as World Peace Ambassador. We would like to ask you, what is your concept of world peace and how we can spread peace in the world?
First of all, let me thank you. Thanks everyone here and Hope Guard Foundation. And I'm the one who writes the lines beautifully and doesn't want actor to make a mistake. But when it comes to my turn, I'm like, oh God, what do I do? So, well, when it comes to world peace, it begins with my mama's story, nothing new theory or new thing, when we were 7 siblings. And whenever we would fight and she would show us picture of, it's like being there from times immemorial, Shiva, a family of Shiva, Parvati, Loin, Nandi, Snake, everybody sitting, and she would always tell us. And especially I'm from a conflicting state, Kashmir, but which is so calm, and people used to go there for spiritualism and seeking peace. So she would always tell us, you know, look at this picture. They're not fighting. They're not out to eat each other. So this is the peace you should have at home. So that was continuous picture which used to be in my mind when I was a naughty kid. So it went on to that, you know, I used to go on the mountain top and say, hey, Pakistan, I want to come there. I wanted that there should be no boundary. I wanted to go to Pakistan and I wanted to tell everybody out there, let's cut the boundaries. But then if you ask me how we can get that peace worldwide, we cannot get it unless we have fear and we have hunger. If I go to people and hungry people who are on the road and say, listen, I'm talking about world peace. Ye bhare pet ke answers hain. Khali pet ko samajh nahi aata peace. So what we need to do is we need to, because that when there is fear, you cannot grow. When there is hunger, you can't do. As Natasha said, education, that is one thing. But I want our children not to be educated by telling them, kama lo, varna bade hoke kya khaoge. That is something everybody does. Telling, creating that fear, you're not going to be earning, you're not going to. Rather than that, I want children of our country, let's talk about our country, peace first, they to be taught education like Gurukul, where you're told, you know, do your karmas and you have to give something to the world. Rather than saying you need to earn, otherwise you will not be respected and your life will go to tombs. One is that world peace for me means hunger, education at that level, and my childhood dream, there is no boundary, there's no politics, there's no religion, and we are just human beings. That's the world peace.
Thank you. you for your lovely elaborate answer. It was very educative. And what is the concept of inner peace?
Inner peace is my mom's peace. Because right now, I'll tell you biggest example, she's in the hospital. This morning she went to hospital and she was bleeding from nose and mouth. And I was so worried that I wanted to miss this occasion. And she is in ICU. And when I thought I'm not coming here, but she recovered within a couple of hours, it was high BP. When I called her, I said, I'm coming. She said, Beta, I've always told you that peace is something you should not leave. Even if I'm leaving the body, my soul is going to be there. So be peaceful because I'm spiritual. So for me, my mom's peace is peace. And I believe expecting nothing from world is just giving and being minimalistic in your requirements and giving a lot to the world. That's inner peace for me.
Thank you for your mother's help, and we hope she recovers fast. And thank you for coming in spite of that.
Thank you.
I request you to have us. Mr. Singh, we wanted to ask you two questions. One is, what is world peace and how we can spread it in the world?
See, world peace, I would say the concept is beautiful. It's the need of the hour, what we see today. We, as being a police officer, I see we are dealing with conflict. As a police officer, we see conflict all around in the society, in the country, and extended to the whole world over. So what we call, despite all the conflicts and the wars going on, what is eluding us? The peace that we want in the world. And the world peace movement that you have started, I would say, is a very noble and a good idea. And I read your brochure that was given to me. The world peace begins from inner peace. Unless and until we have inner peace, the world peace cannot be there. So inner peace, the seven values that you have given to the world, gratitude, forgiveness, love, truth, what are the other? Humility, giving, and patience, and truth. So if each and every person follows these values, I am sure that you will be peaceful within. And if you are a peaceful individual within, you will emanate peace. You will be a person who is at peace with himself. And somebody who is at peace with himself, there will be peace in the family. And a peace in the family brings about peace in the society. And you extend that logic beyond, you will have world peace. But there is a long way to go. Utopian concept, but we should strive for it. And I congratulate you for that, for taking that step.
Thank you for your very lovely answer. We wanted to ask you, what is your concept of inner peace?
See, inner peace, if you follow the seven values, automatically you will be a person with inner peace. May be difficult, but I'm self-satisfied. I have not much of desires, and I am truthful, giving, loving, and if you all do these principles that you have laid down, automatically you bring inner peace with you. You are not at conflict with yourselves. Conflict arises when my desires and my abilities or what are different from the reality. So we have to reduce our desires, as they say, the Buddhist philosophy, reduce your desires. That will bring you much more of inner peace and happiness.
Thank you. I think you have read a lot on all this. And thank you for your lovely answers. Thank you for coming. Thank you. Kirtiji, congratulations on being felicitated as World Peace Ambassador. We would like to ask you, what is your concept of world peace and how we can spread peace in the world?
Everyone's given such good answers that I don't have much left to speak about. But I feel that the entire world is divided into caste, creed, religion, countries, various rituals that you have. I believe that there is one thing which is very common amongst us, that's spirituality. And that's what we should have. I believe that it's the entire world is united by blood. When we go to, say, maybe a blood bank, We don't look into which caste, creed, or religion a person belongs to. If my blood group is the same as yours, then we can give blood to each other. We don't see which caste or creed or religion we come from. And that is what brings in animosity. That is what we got to take away and think about in modern world that we are living in. Those were medieval days when people used to annex new grounds and boundaries and go take countries and try and show their rule by the might of the sword. Now it has to be that universal brotherhood, Vasudev Kutumbakam, that used to be talked about, that the entire world is one family. And until unless we don't feel like that and there is animosity amongst people because of caste, creed, religion, we'll not have world peace.
Thank you. Very lovely answer about the blood bank and all. Very nice. No one has said it.
I have a long answer, but we have got it short.
Yes.
More than 5 minutes for
us. Okay. And the second question is, what's your concept of inner peace?
I would say nirvana, salvation.
Yes.
See, when I was young and when I was playing cricket, and I used to have bad times when maybe I had not scored runs, and you know, my father would look at me and say, "Beta, agar achhe din nahi rahe, to bure din bhi nahi rahe." So it always happens. It's not necessary that every day would be a good day, and so you get disturbed. There's a materialistic world where there is too much of material everywhere, and you are looking for new goals. A person is greedy. So when you say nirvana and salvation is when you want to get rid of that and believe in your karma. Once you believe in your karma and say, "Achha, achhe din nahi rahe, to bure bhi nahi rahenge." If good days haven't stayed, bad days won't stay with you. So think that way. That doesn't give you an intention, gives you a lot of peace. Think positive.
So lovely answer. So karma is the best thing. And that's very well said in the holy books. And thank you for coming here.
Thank you very much.
We request you to have a seat.
Thank you.
Congratulations on being a World Peace Ambassador. We would like to ask you, what's your concept of world peace and how we can spread peace in the world?
Well, you know, when it comes to world peace right now, I think we are really lacking in the world right now with the kind of conflicts that we see in everyday's news, be it between nations, between countries, between people, religion and everything. So for me, I think world peace will be something where it starts from the basic root level, that is education. If we can nurture minds for the youth and the next generation to come, I think world peace can be attained, because education is something that is going to change individuals as a person when it starts at home. And that is exactly what I'm attaining, and I think that is possible. Congratulations.
Thank you for your nice answer about education. We would like to ask you, what is your concept of inner peace?
Well, I think, you know what, inner peace is a state of psychological, state of mind for me, because it can be spiritual, it can be psychological. Why? Because in today's world, right, we have so much of pressure, everybody over here, you know, like I think peace is a kind of a catalyst. If one person is having disturbed mind over here, that person, you know, like a contagious disease that's moving on everyone's mind, that one person is not happy or the peace is not there, it's kind of, you know, spreading everywhere. So I personally feel that the inner peace is something in today's world, the kind of pressure we have on each other for work, for everything, for daily day activities, families, we can attain at home. And starting at home, understanding yourself psychologically and spiritually. And as how Dr. Meeni said that, you know, a smile can change the world. Offer a smile.
Thank you. Very nice answer, and thank you for coming. Atiji, congratulations on being felicitated as World Peace Ambassador.
Thank you.
We would like to ask you, what is your concept of world peace and how we can spread peace in the world?
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Chris. I'm very humbled to be here. First of all, I've heard a lot about world peace, the whole program which is going on since long time. I was previously also called for this particular thing, but I was not very confident. Now I've met you and I've spoken to you over the period of time. So yes, this makes me feel nice. I've been working for world peace. Besides having this sachet and besides having all the trophies and gifts you have given me. I'm very glad. I would like to add on to this. We all talk about peace. We all work on peace. But the thing is that the peace starts from within. And world is whatever all around the planet, the whole universe. If we all begin from within us, then only we can win and survive in this world. Every individual, every person, and every family is responsible for the peace of the world. So if we do not have that little small ethic of having that peace within us, we can't, ask for the world to have peace. And we cannot even voice ourselves, neither we can fight for it, neither we can protest for it. So what we have to do is, what you asked me, that what is my inner peace and what is outside world peace, everything initiates for me within. Inner peace. Everything begins for me within. I believe if I am peaceful, if I am happy, if I am perfectly all right, my mind, body and soul is aligned, then everything around me and everybody around me will be happy. And there won't be any reason to complain. And whichever association I join, like this World Peace Ambassador you have made me today, and we all are working, there are 2 million people you are saying, so we all are working for this particular cause. If every individual is not working within, it's no point associating, clubbing them together. So that's my idea.
So your concept is that with the inner peace, the world peace will come.
Yes.
And do you have any thought like how inner peace we can get, or any idea on that?
Yes, yes, yes. Inner peace is your daily routine. How you begin your day, how you initiate the first step, like when the moment you open your eyes, when you wake up from your bed, what you do, how you feel. I will give only my example. Every morning I wake up and I chant this mantra. Brahma Murari Tapurandakari Bhanu Sashi Bhumi Suta Budasya Guru Shashukra Shani Rahu Ketu Sarve Graha Suprabhatam Shanti Bhavantu. This is my first mantra when I wake up. I look at my palm, I look at the floor, I check my breath, and I always say, thank you God, I'm breathing. My heart is beating. I'm alive. I check my family, my children, they are alive, they are fine, I'm happy. Then the relatives, then the world, then all the social media, everybody. Because I have something around 4 million people on my Facebook, so it is my responsibility to inspire them too. So every morning without seeing sunrise or sharing a tiny 10 second video of morning sunrise, which I don't fail to see, I share it with them too. Regardless, they like it, they don't like it, it's my story. And everybody loves that. Om Suryaya Namah, I always say that. Om Adityaya Namah, Om Bhaskaraya Namah. The energy, the solar energy, the Om chant, which is universal. Even Muslims say Allah, Ameen. Christians say Amen. Hindus say Om. Everything means Om. That's the sound of the earth. Am I right? That's the sound. And that's the sound we have to have within. The moment everything, we start. And when we end our day, when we go to sleep, I every day, thank God, I feel lot of gratitude for whatever I have. Like today you are honoring me. I'm really humbled. I have no idea like what has inspired you to choose me. but I am very humbled that you have given me this opportunity to carry this flag for the world. So in the whole circle, I live every day at a time. That's what I did it in pandemic. I had only 35,000 followers before, 50,000 before pandemic began. And every day when I was seeing the news of this coronavirus and all these issues and problems, every day my heart used to cry. And every day I used to feel that agar mere se kuch bhi ho sakta hai, thoda sa bhi, to main inke liye karungi. To main every day main chote chote 2-3 minute ke videos inke liye dalti thi. I don't know when it exploded, what happened in this 1 year that it went to 4 million. I have no idea how much these people have given me love. So it's my responsibility for them to be always stay inspired, stay focused, stay stable, and as much positivity I can spread, I should spread. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Aditi, for your inspiring message. And very lovely. And so much passion you spoke.
Thank you.
Both are very lovely.